Welcome to the final version of the Cajon Valley Broadcast. Happy summer, everybody. I'm here with our cabinet, and we're just going to have a conversation and talk about some exciting things. And John, did you know that we're launching a high school next year?
I do know we're launching a high school. It'll be our inaugural class. Very excited to support that program this summer and get it built up and support them next year.
So I heard that we're not just enrolling freshmen, but...
sophomores too. So we're going to have a freshman class and a sophomore class, and we're excited to welcome them.
And there's still a few more spots for sophomores, so register now, go online, and it's Bostonia Global. But we're excited about next year having our first freshman and sophomore class. And speaking of class, we just had an amazing round of TEDx speakers grace the stage. And Ed, you participated in that.
Absolutely. It was incredible to see three panels participate. Of course, we had parents, students, teachers, people from the community. They were all involved. It was an incredible experience. Seventh year, Dr. Miyashiro, seventh year.
So in year one or two, you were a TEDx speaker here as a Qualcomm employee.
That was a crazy foreshadowing, because in 2015, you invited me to unleash a TEDx talk, How Does a Child Aspire to a Career They Don't Know Exist? So to be many years later on the stage with teachers and students who are actually doing the work, oh my goodness, what a blessing it is for me to be serving this community. Thank you so much. Thank you, the cabinet, but it's an honor to serve you. But TEDx Kids, amazing.
And then you did a panel this last time?
Did a panel this time. We had a first grader, her teacher, Michelle Smith, and we also had an eighth grader who's promoting to high school, and that eighth grader's mom, who also happens to be one of our family and community engagement liaisons. So to see that communication and that conversation between a first grader and eighth grader, a first grade teacher and a parent, it blew me away, truly.
Well, we're thankful to Jim Petraglia, the entire TEDx team, and let's check out this video.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to TEDx Kids at El Cajon. Thank you so much for allowing us to share our evening with you.
It is my dream to inspire others to never stop dreaming and to always have something you want to do or want to have. Go and throw your rock. See how many ripples you can get and ultimately how many lives you can change.
La vida es un ratito. Are you ready to go out, make a difference, and be a hero?
Believe it's been 7 years. This is our seventh annual TEDx Kids at El Cajon, and every year I am truly inspired by the ideas and courageous experiences our kids have to share with us.
I'm really glad I'm doing this, because in my past self, I would never thought I'd be doing this right now.
So try something new. Our creative ideas can last beyond the pandemic.
And cheers to all those women and girls who continue to follow their passion for STEM no matter what.
So when you're determined to do something and you want to do it, even if you have a medical condition, take all of your worries and push them aside. You can do it.
Although this year has been rough for a lot of us,
we're still getting through this together.
Weren't our kids awesome? It's amazing what Cajon Valley has done and our kids and experiences they're having. If you want to see the entire video, go to our website.
Speaking of stages, promotions, wow, what a week we've had. Right, Scott?
Isn't it fantastic? We're finally past the pandemic like we saw last year. No more drive-through graduations, promotions. We had in-person. Obviously, safety is key. Six-foot distancing, etc. But we had a more realistic promotion. And I just want to shout out to Flying Hills and Crest, our first eighth grade classes this year. So how exciting.
Yes. And some creativity out there. So let's see some video of some of the amazing creativity with our promotions this year.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you for all the teachers and staff that made a memorable experience for our students and their families. And speaking of families, one of the things that we heard this year early in some of our meetings, Scott, with our stakeholders is, my kid is in fifth grade, and they're going to miss Biztown this year. Karen, you've been a teacher and a principal in our district. What are your recollections of Biztown and what it means to our fifth graders and their families?
I think it's a little bit of a tradition they look forward to. It's a hands-on experience where everybody has an important role. I think every student looks forward to that day. What I love in Cajon Valley is we used to think of that as just an isolated day in fifth grade, and it was something in many of the traditions we missed last year. But I am so thankful to, and I want to congratulate our fifth grade class for, with a little notice from Junior Achievement, you got the curriculum together, our students had in-person preparation, and many, many of our fifth grade classes went to Biztown this year. And we're finally back to off-campus, meaningful learning experiences. We are so excited. Take a look at this video. It will make you smile.
So everyone always asks us, what do we want to be when we grow up? We're learning about it in classrooms with World of Work. We're seeing it out in our community. And now our kids are going to really have that firsthand experience at Biztown, where they get to be that professional for the day. Our fifth graders in Cajon Valley are so excited and fortunate to have this great firsthand experience for a career that they might be dreaming of now.
We need kids to know what kinds of jobs are out there for them. They need to know how to spend their money, how to make money, how to track their spending. So one of the neat components of this program is the fact that it's experiential. So the kids are experiencing earning a paycheck and spending their money and tracking their money. And what's really neat is how it translates into the real world, because that's exactly what adults do every day. So they get to learn firsthand what it's like to be an adult, but in a really fun and engaging experience.
Junior Achievement as a whole is focused on empowering young people through financial literacy, work readiness, and entrepreneurship. And one of the really unique ways that we do that is through the McGrath Family JA Biztown. What the program focuses really on is creating a mini city and allowing young people to have jobs and careers and interact as adults. It's an opportunity for young people, fifth graders, to live life, real adult life, before they have to go out and live it. We are so proud and excited to partner with Cajon Valley School District, because their World of Work program aligns so nicely with the work that we do around the county. It's really preparing young people, starting at kindergarten, to be ready for their future economic success.
It's really important for the kiddos to connect what they learn in school and in their classrooms with what is actually going on in the world. Transportation Department is really happy to support that. We've been doing field trips as much as possible to connect these kids to the work that they are learning about and possibly the work that they're going to do in the future. We're giving them those options about what direction they want to head in life.
My brothers went to Biztown too, and now they know how to use money. They have jobs. And it wasn't long ago when they went to Biztown, and you just learn how to do it before you're grown up, so that way you don't have to worry about wanting to get, it's not gonna be hard when you grow up.
We are really excited to be here at Biztown today. It's been really fun to watch the children take all of their classroom lessons and put them into play here at Biztown. It's amazing how well Biztown really works well with the World of Work. Here they're able to see exactly how a community works and how businesses work, how jobs work, and how money works within the community to make the community thrive. So it's been a really fabulous experience, and I'm sure that in the future it's going to be a wonderful experience for our students to continue every year.
Thank you so much to Junior Achievement, Sid Vivek, CEO, for allowing us to come to Biztown. And there was a star in there, Tyson Broderdoff, who talked about some of the work. Tyson's part of your team, Scott. Can you tell us about what had to happen to get our kids to Biztown?
Yeah, you know, everything like is different this year. Transportation is no exception. You know, making sure we have kids spaced out safely on the buses. And that was something that a lot of our schools necessarily every year don't get to go and experience. Transportation's a cost usually that, you know, schools can't afford. And we stepped up and helped support that. And transportation, all the drivers and dispatchers, they made it all fit into the normal schedule, and we were able to get all the schools to participate this year. So we're so thankful for our drivers who committed that extra time to get our kids down there and participate.
And transportation, thank you for inviting us to ice cream day yesterday. It's the first time I had a giant-sized bomb pop since I was a kid. So thank you for that. And speaking of stars in education, there's stars everywhere. And transportation, IT, print shop, ed services, warehouse, ed services, and personnel. Tell us about stars in education and what just happened.
Yeah, you know, all these amazing things that are happening across the district happen because of the people that we have doing that work. And one of the things that we've changed recently with the Stars in Education is instead of a group of outside people identifying those folks that are on campus that are really being the absolute star, both classified and certificated, those nominations are now coming from each individual school site and or each individual department. And so it really is a team approach, and also their own colleagues who are recognizing their great work and really elevating them and putting them on stage. And so we have a video for you today in order to see all of the stars that we've had across the entire district for both the 1920 and the 2021 school year. And we're just so incredibly proud of them and very appreciative for the work that they've done in order to provide our students with the experiences that they have each and every day that they come to school in Cajon Valley. So thank you, and please stick around and watch the whole entire video because they're amazing people.
And thank you guys for being good sports and impromptu doing the last broadcast. Happy summer, Cajon Valley.
We just got Mushroom.